session, you attacked Atl totally without provocation, and now you're going to fight her, he, it.
Well, shit, yeah,
Oh,
we did.
you did.
I stabbed her already with the thingies, right? So she's
Yes.
stunned for a round.
We also built. Did we finish the building? The
Yeah.
crafting?
That was the 48 hours we spent working on.
Yes, I
Oh,
believe you finished all
24.
of the crafting and
Yeah.
all that stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so we had a long rest at one point.
Yes, after all the
Yes,
work.
yes, yes, yes.
Good.
Okay. I guess we roll initiative.
Yes, all right. So with this, we're gonna roll. We're gonna go for yes, all right. So everyone roll initiative.
Our tokens are down, all right.
This character always rolls a really low initiative. Well,
Chess
he's
is
a
just
tanky guy, so it
unpredictable.
makes sense. Plus, it's not bad for the healer to get low initiative.
True.
Tina Sash Tank.
Look on the positive side of life.
Yeah.
Maybe it's too early to say that to Jeff.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Right now, I'm lucky if I can even keep my eyes open, honestly.
The once the combat starts, it's going to be very, you know.
I'll throw big numbers at Jeff to make sure he's awake.
I
Yeah.
mean, when I first got here, I was thinking I'm early again, so I was like 2 seconds from laying down, and I was like, I better ask them just to make sure. And honestly, when you said I wasn't early, there was a twinge of disappointment.
Oh, I feel that Oh, when I'm tired, I'm terrible.
Is completely understandable to me that feeling. But all right, so okay. Justin has stabbed Athel.
Stabity stab.
Actually, I've used my both of my attack actions, so
Yes, okay, yes, but one of them hit and the other one missed.
yes, so that's my turn, I guess. From me outgoing in the initiative.
Well, it was what started, so I would consider that a
Yeah, that's what
surprise.
started, so I would call that kind of like an ambush round.
Oh, nice. All right. Then she start.
Yes. Okay, so Klaatu.
I would cast bone armor on myself. And for my bonus action, I command my skeletons to attack Atl. Kaminsky,
Skeleton.
Klaus, Klaatu, Kira, Cord, Claire, Clara, attack Atl. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
With
Right, we
advantage because
calculated
she
Atl
spent.
has an AC of 22, and
Okay.
so one of those will hit.
Ouch! 22?
Yes.
This is gonna be
Yeah,
fun,
draw.
guys. Because she's
Draw.
still being Mist's form.
So,
Oh, that's right.
12 damage.
Can we
12
somehow
damage.
dispel that or something?
Those are just from like bow attacks. What type of attacks are they?
Yeah, that's bow attacks.
Okay.
They have ranged and melee.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, then. As a legendary action, Atl is going to use the return to self. Atl removes any conditions upon itself and changes form.
Mm-hmm. I'm okay with
form
that.
Depends on the roll. All right, so they rolled a 9. The 9 is the vine form. So, going to change to the vine.
That should mean a change in AC, guys. I certainly hope so.
All right. Okay, so Atl has adopted the vine form. Can I show this to you guys? Ah, there we go.
Sweet. All
right, it's loading. Okay. All right, Atl assumes the vine form, and as it does, let me go down. I get at least, there's a lot of abilities. Okay, all right. Okay, so upon taking this form, a burst of poisonous vine. So basically, she returns to herself and protrudes a bunch of poisonous vines that expel from its core as she takes this form. Basically, like it's almost as if she collapses into herself and then bursts out of this form. Everyone within 20 feet must make a dexterity saving throw. That includes Mist, Oruba, two of the skeletons, and Jastin.
Do we get advantage or something because of Mist?
You get Aura? A +3.
+3.
Yeah.
That makes it 9, but as a reaction, I'm going to activate my new armor.
That's dexterity, right?
Yes.
Crap.
And I'm going to gain 25 health points temporary. Whoop. And whenever I take damage from a source and it is within melee to me, it takes the damage back. Like 25. Cold. Good to see. Or suffer. Well, I'm immune against poison.
Okay. Half of the damage. So 44 is poison, 44 is piercing. But because of the way that. But I couldn't. I had to put in piercing plus poison.
No worries, but I take no poison damage and I take half of piercing damage. So how much do I take?
Alright, let's half it then to 13, and then halving that would be 6.
Right, so I take 6 damage from my temporary hit points. She still takes 25 cold damage.
Okay. Alright then.
So, and it's piercing and poison, right? So
I'm going to put an aura on her because it's difficult terrain around her. Of 20 feet. Everyone should be able to see this. Okay, it, you can all see the aura.
Does it move with her?
It moves with her, yes.
Okay.
Yes, okay, so all of this area is difficult terrain, and it's basically like spike growth. You move within it, you can get damage.
How much damage did we get from the vine directly?
The vines, you got 27 piercing and divided into piercing and poison.
Okay.
All right, then. Alright, so, on Atl's turn, the creature is going to move, take a step back into the...
Oh, if she moves, I get an opportunity attack now.
All right, no, she's not going to. She's going to use the Thorn Barrage on a 90-foot cone, basically hitting everyone then. She's going to choose this, basically a huge cone, that she's just going to unleash hell on, of like a torrent of little, like, sharpened poisonous projectiles are thrown at all of you.
On a successful take, you take half or no damage. It doesn't say that.
On, you take half. Wait, let me see.
So I take half.
Yeah.
Okay.
I apparently take half as well.
11, 6. And because she's into melee with me, she takes 25 cold damage again.
Are you?
I think that if you're out of the temporary hit points, wait, do you still have the?
Yeah, of course. I lost 12.
Ah, yeah. Okay.
I have 13 left.
David, isn't half of that's poison, so you only take half anyway, right?
Yes, but then I am immune against piercing.
Oh.
Like I take half damage from non-magical bludgeoning and everything.
But you succeeded the saving throw.
Yes, so I take half, half, and half of it.
Oh, damn.
I halved it 3 times.
Lucky ass bastard.
Yeah, that's what I asked in the beginning, so, if I should half and half and half again.
Okay. This will include Klaatu and all of his little skeletons as well.
Little widdle skeletons.
Okay, so she takes 25 points of damage again then.
That's cold.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this thing is taking too much damage, guys.
Okay.
She kinda and... strong.
Alright, so this is the first part of the multi-attack that she does. So she does this Thorn Barrage. Then she will do a poisonous slash on Justin with a natural one, which will just miss. And then she will turn to do a poisonous shot with disadvantage, but on Klaatu with a 20 to hit.
Yeah, this... Oh, wait. I use my reaction and form a skeletal shield. No, it must hit and to succeed, right? Oh, then forget my reaction.
What do you mean?
Why do you think it wouldn't work?
Because then I have an AC of 20 and would still.
But did you not cast your armor beforehand in your round?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. And so it's 15, but with the plus 5, it would be 20.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, would hit.
Well, that sucks.
All right then. So the poisonous shot hits. Okay. So. It's a really heavy shot that pierces through you into your stomach, dealing 48 points of piercing, 14 points of poison. And you must make a constitution saving throw, or you are poisoned.
Yeah. Do I have you? No. Okay. Con save coming. Oh. Wait, that's enough.
Alright, you fail. Every turn, starting now, you lose 5 feet of movement.
Okay.
If you get to zero movement, you are petrified.
And petrified is like in stone?
Yes, in stone.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
All right then, Orba, your turn.
If I move now, I already get hit, right?
Yes, you're already in the area.
I have to look how well...
Plato, did you make the saving throw for your skeletons as well? For the barrage?
For the barrage? Was the first? No, the thorn barrage? No, I didn't.
Yeah, the thorn barrage.
That was the second thing she did, right? Because for the first I did...
Thorn barrage was 45.
Yeah, okay, the thorn barrage must... I must do two dex. One, two. No one gets it, so... The first 10. 1, 8, 12, 14. 14. 16. 26, so, okay. So, Clara's dead. No, Clara!
Alright, yeah. Let's put it a square for some sake. Okay. Okay, Oriba, it is your turn.
Yes, so I will move out. And if I move here, could I still throw at her underneath the mushroom?
Yeah. You will take the 4d4 points of damage as you are leaving.
Yeah.
But yes, you can throw the... Okay, so the first two are poison, the first two are piercing, the second two are poison. So that is a total of 8 points of damage.
And then I throw a painkiller bomb at Jess.
Yes, my mate, that's a good idea.
That's 13 temp HP.
Ooh, does that mean also that the spell is going to last longer? Because so, now I get back to 20.
HP doesn't stack.
All right, so I have to keep track of the 13 from. Of course, it does stack. If you get 13 temporary HP and the next spell gives 25, you have 38.
No, you don't.
No, you do not.
You have 25 because.
Don't do it then.
The larger spell.
Going to make my spell disappear then.
Then I'm just gonna throw a frost bomb.
Just deal damage, mate.
But if I throw no bomb, I hit you too.
But you have the thing I gave you, which you can just concentrate the bomb's explosion on. Can you not?
Oh, did we do that?
Yes, of course. We finished this.
Oh.
You can add it to a firebomb, and then it does... just single damage without the explosion.
All right, then I do that with a normal bomb.
I have to say, Justin's contributions to the group were pretty big. Masks, this shit.
Got 21.
Ooh.
Okay then, all right. So, the bomb hit. The HP of the creature is reduced, so the bomb does hit. Right. It is vulnerable to fire as the leaves and the vines that form it suddenly catch on fire. It seems that perhaps the poison itself is vulnerable as well, is flammable. So she will take, that will be 78 points of damage from that attack.
And I will prepare still a painkiller bomb for my bonus action.
Right there. Okay, is that your turn then?
Yes.
Alright, Atul will take a legendary action to make she will take a legendary action to take a poisonous shot against Oraba. Oraba, you are under half cover, considering you are hiding behind the mushroom, but that is still a 30 to hit.
That hits me. That hits pretty hard.
Yes.
I will use Fade Away.
Make a constitution saving throw?
As well.
What is fade away?
Concept. Oh no. Fade away just makes me invisible.
Ah, okay.
Okay. And it's a poison.
Yes.
Alright, I still use the fade away to become invisible.
Thing must think it's beaten you.
Right then. So, Justin, your turn.
Alright, I'm trying to stun it again using the knife. I still have the soul cutter in my hand.
Wait, didn't you stun it last time?
Yes, but it used a legendary thing to break free from it.
Oh.
So,
screw that.
Do I have any pluses on my attack? No. So, it's a 15 on the first.
Okay,
does that
15
hit?
Will miss.
And that's 29 on the second attack.
29 will hit.
And I'm going to sever the soul again.
Hmm?
And I'm going to circle around her, walking into the water, cutting off her escape, and I'm going to try to jump so as the vines have a harder time grappling me.
Make an acrobatics check.
Acrobatics! I'm 15.
You end up tumbling away. You end up tumbling a little bit of a distance, and you are stabbed basically with one set of the poison. So that will be, I think, for you, because you are immune to poison, that's 2d4 halved. So that is 1 point of damage.
And does that happen while I am passing her? Because then she takes the 25.
That happens whilst... basically, what happens is you jump over her. As you land in the river, you tumble a little bit away.
And then she stabs me. And then I take the damage, right?
No, the vines themselves stab you. She does not take a... Because it was accidental, she does not take a...
Okay.
An opportunity attack against you. It's like you were pushed. It's like as if you were pushed before.
Okay. Yep. Then there's no trigger from the armor. Okay, Oh, cool. I want to get in melee with her, though.
Hmm?
Wait. That's not a bonus action, is it? No. It's a bonus action. That's one, but I need those spells. Okay, no. I'm going to remain here for the moment. She's stunned. Have a go at her. So you see, as I go with the blade through her again, there's something following the blade as it goes out of her before it then dissipates into nothingness again.
All right. Mist, your turn.
Okay, I guess I'm running up here, so whatever damage I take for doing.
Okay, how much damage is that? How much did you move?
I was, right there.
Okay, alright, so that's 3 steps. Alright, that is 12d4 points of damage then. Alright, that's 33 points of damage.
Okay, I'll step in here. And touch Klaatu, healing him for 13 using lay on hands, which means it should cure him of his poison and
petrified.
Yeah, petrification issues.
Okay.
Oh.
Right.
How much health was that?
Thanks, Mist.
What was that, Orba?
How much health? You healed me, right?
No, he healed Klaatu.
Oh, okay.
I'm working on it.
Yeah, it's fun. I'm still in this.
And looks like Jastin, you haven't been injured, right? I mean, it's all hit your temp hit points, right?
I have still my temp hit points.
Okay, then
I have hit it. Let's
see. Okay, and I will use as a bonus action. Song of Melora, which is mass healing word. And I'll use it at I'm going to go 4th level.
6.
So that's 17 to Oruba, myself, and Klaatu.
Sweet. Also, perhaps Cleo? One of my skeletons?
Yeah, she needs it.
Nice. I like it.
Don't forget to give yourself your health, Orba, because...
14 healing?
17.
17.
Okay. Alright, is that your turn, Beast?
And using the... Haste Potion in the mass, that's a free action, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay, then I'm going to pop that and use another action.
Nice.
Inhaling
the haste. Like being on cocaine or something.
Pretty heavy cocaine.
Yes.
Actually, you know, I'm not going to do that yet.
You're not going to use the haste?
Not yet.
Okay.
I will hold off on that. So, my turn's over.
Okay, then. All right. Klaatu, your turn.
Okay. First, I command my skeletons. Keep distance! Attack further! And from skeletons werden schießen. Pew!
Oh, at advantage.
At advantage, okay.
One, yeah, she's two, still stunned, isn't she?
Yes.
Until the end. Five. So, 24 hits with 8 damage. It's also a crit, so one another d6, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So for 12 damage. And what was 15 also? No. Yes? No?
What do you mean? What are you asking?
Would 15 hit?
15 would not, no.
Okay, then just this 12. Oh, nice music.
12 points of damage then. Alright.
And I will... will cast...
She is vulnerable to fire.
I can cast the fire on smashing spirits. I thought about polymorphing me into an ape because I have more hit points then. But a raging spirit will do. I will cast it at the level... This 20-foot range. Yes, I used Clara for you. I think I can place it so nobody but her get hits. But I
wait.
No, that's fine. I mean, wait, isn't Clara dead?
Yeah, I just use her for the fireball.
Ah, for measuring. Okay.
Yeah, like this.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I wasn't going to fuss about that. All right. Yeah,
just wanted to see.
Hey David, you're breaking up really bad. I'm not sure what's going on with your mic.
Can you hear me better now?
Much better.
Yeah, I'm trying to smoke. You could use your upgrade as well, right? You can choose to make the spell cast at a higher level.
Oh yeah, next time. I didn't say so.
Okay. So this is doubled then to be 58 points of damage.
Doubles would be like...
Yes, because she's vulnerable to fire.
Then would be like 35, doubled is 70.
Oh, it's 35. Yes, sorry. I forgot the 6.
Never mind.
I was only reading the 29. Okay. Yes, you're totally right.
And then I would step away a little bit. Oh no, I step in the aura of mist, like here. Mm-hmm. And my skeletons will follow, making a wall.
Okay.
Okay, that's it.
All right then. We go to her turn. She is still stunned, and she will be stunned until the start of Justin's turn.
Yeah, start of my turn.
Yeah. Okay then. So she is still stunned. Orava.
I will drink a healing potion as a bonus action. How much were they? I forgot already.
What kind is it?
Greater has power. Okay.
Greater is 44 plus 4.
Alright. And then I will throw another bomb at her.
25. Okay, that'll hit. 30 points of damage, double ends up being 62. All right. Okay. Is that your turn?
Yes.
Okay then. Justin, her soul, it seems like she reawakens as she and she looks at you with great intensity, seeking revenge.
Yeah, but I'm going to lunge towards her with the soul cutter in my hand.
Okay, alright. You will suffer the 2d4. Okay, so you suffer 1 point of damage again.
Mm-hmm. Okay. 11 temporary hit points left. Mm-hmm. So, first attack, soul cutter. Mm-hmm. It's a 22.
That was it.
And I'm going to use the last soul sever on it.
Okay. Alright, so that is 8 piercing damage, and again, you, like, in this case, you can even visibly see a distancing between the body and the soul, almost as if there is a creaking in the vines as the soul is propelled and pushed away.
Alright, with my other attack then, like, I imagine I lunged at her, so I'm kind of standing on this vine mass with the soul cutter in one hand, and with the other hand I'm going to zip the pepper box into my hand, and it would be at disadvantage because of melee, but also at advantage because she's in this stunned state.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to shoot using a trial by fire bullet, and also using grit to make it a violent shot. So if I roll a 4, it's a misfire already, a 4 or below.
Okay. And this is a regular attack, then?
It's a regular attack. Whoa.
Okay. That is an 8 roll, and...
Alright, I'm going to add a d6 to it with the Pact Boon Watch. So, that's a 20 to hit.
Okay, that will hit. So basically, you see that as you pull your gun and you shoot it, there is a point where the bullet hits the creature's armor and is about to be chinked off, but the power of your watch beckons the bullet into, and it you see how it changes trajectory into the creature. The 19 points of damage.
And 7 fire damage doubled to 14.
Fire damage doubled, 14 fire damage.
All right.
Okay.
Then I'm going to action surge.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to lunge off of her. Ooh, like do a backflip.
Yeah.
Land back here. Okay. And I'm going to fire two more times. And I'm going to use... So they are at advantage.
Yeah.
So I'm going to use a grit on both shots to make them violent. Ah, I forgot the violent on this one as well. So sorry, it's additional d10. Two additional to the 19.
Ah, okay. All right.
So because it's a violent 19. Shot.
Okay, so there's an extra 10 points of damage.
All right, so wait, now...
Is that additional 10 points of damage?
No, no, it's two just D6? Two. It's two damage.
Ah, it's just two, okay.
Yes, it's an additional D10 because it's a violent shot. Mm-hmm. So now okay, I'm going now. To do the first shot. It's a trial by fire, violent shot, bullet with a 23 to hit, plus 14 fire, and an additional D10. So 21 plus 14 fire.
Okay.
And the second attack is a 21 plus an additional d10. Oh, that's sad. Do I have this feature where I can reroll once on my... No, I don't have it because I never leveled up. All right, so 18 piercing and 14 fire on this one. Two hey. Additional trial by fire bullets. And this should have been, let's say... 10, 20, and I would like to bonus action. Is it a bonus action to pull out the canopic edge?
I think so. It would be to draw it, yes.
All right, then I'm going to switch weapons between the thingy and the soul cutter and canopic edge, and then I'm going to move into melee again, snapping the pepper box away. I'm going to get really
okay, so that is another 2 points of damage that you suffer.
Yes. Give me the damage. All right, I have 9 temporary hit points left. All right, and she's stunned again. She's stunned That's again. The end of my turn.
Yes. All right, okay. As a legendary action, she will, at the end of your turn, use the return to self and change her appearance again. Change her form. Again, this time to the sixth form.
Well, at least we get rid of the aura, right?
That will get rid of the aura, yes.
But what is the sixth form? What kind of nasty stuff do you have waiting for us with that?
Yes.
You changed into her tar form.
Oh, great.
Alright,
what form?
Upon taking this form, Athol spews out sticky flammable tar to all creatures within 15 feet. All of them must succeed a DC 20 dexterity saving throw or become vulnerable to fire and become under the effect of the slow spell.
Ooh.
A creature may use an action to shake off the tar, succeeding on an acrobatics or athletics roll of 20.
Interesting.
So this is just Justin.
Right, so I have to make a what save?
Dexterity save.
You can do it, Justin.
Whoop.
Yes.
20.
You succeed.
Very good.
All right. You succeed the tar.
I imagine because I'm standing in the water, it's just becoming hardened, and Justin keeps jumping on the hardened tar bits.
Yes. Okay, so you are able to avoid the tar explosion, basically, that comes out of her change of form. Mist, your turn. What happened to the music? Are you guys listening to it?
No.
Nope.
Be going on and off for me. Okay, all right. Well, I clicked it on the player. Okay. All right, Miss, your turn.
Are you guys comfortable with your health, or do you want me to heal you some more?
You can take a potion next round, I guess. Another.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too.
Okay. Then I am going to... free action that haste potion now.
Mm-hmm.
And I will charge forward. And... said something about her being vulnerable to fire.
Oh, that isn't anymore, I guess.
No.
Yeah, we don't know. She's in her.
You don't know. She changed form. The form. The last form was vulnerable to fire. This form might be. It depends.
Okay. Well, I'm going to. Bonus action. Holy weapon.
Holy weapon.
And then is she undead by any chance?
You don't know.
Okay, well, this will do more damage if she's undead, so where is it? And I have advantage, so 23.
23 will hit.
Again, I have... we'll do more damage if it's undead. I just need to know.
Mm-hmm. Alright. So, is it only radiant damage that you are dealing?
Oh, wait. I don't have... I didn't Divine Strike. Oh, yeah, I did. Never mind. No. I will turn the sword damage to fire instead of radiant.
Okay.
So the 8 would be fire.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so as you slice through, you are able to hit the creature, but you find that the whole creature seems to be entirely made out of this strange tar that partially... consumes and makes it. As you're passing by the sword, the whole creature catches on fire.
Okay.
But it does not seem to be affected by it. It is on fire, and it gives off this incredible flammable heat that comes off of it. Like, it is effectively starting to burn the area around it.
Okay. Might have to do something about that. Okay, I'll swing again.
So, it is immune to fire, but do you also deal any radiant damage? Because it's not immune to that.
Yeah, I've got, it's 6 damage currently as radiant. Okay. An additional 4 if it's undead, and then...
It is not undead.
Okay. So it's 6 radiant damage.
Okay. Alright, so it suffers 6 points of radiant damage.
Okay, then I will switch the blade back to radiant damage. So it's another 18. And then I will take a couple steps back here. Oh, wait.
All right. So, okay, so that will hit. That's 18 points of damage. it will make an opportunity attack against you.
That's fine.
Actually, it cannot. It does not have a melee attack.
I'm okay. Alright. And then for my action, my hasted action, I will use a new spell.
Scalding geyser.
Geyser, I will call out to Melora. Beseech her aid. And a hole will open just at her feet. And a burst of scalding water will burst forth and shoot 40 feet high. Unfortunately, just I will move it. Basically, I'll position it so Jasmine doesn't get hurt.
Okay.
So, right here,
It's simple enough. Okay. So that is 4d6 fire and 4d6 radiant. So it will take the radiant damage, which is 11.
I was hoping with it being water, you would make it water damage, but that's okay. I was hoping
it's not fire. Cold. It's really, really hot water, and it doesn't seem affected by it.
I know. I should have thought of that before I used it. Where is it?
Very flavorful.
Okay, so I guess 18 points of damage.
Okay, I'm going to make a dexterity saving throw.
That's kind of...
And, yeah, okay. It will fail.
It's kind of a lousy spell choice, guys. Sorry.
No, it doesn't matter. It's all...
Does it...
Okay, maybe
does
you it can change twice? It up.
What's that?
Does maybe it shoot can... twice, or are you casting it twice?
I was just rolling the damage on it. That's what that second one is.
Ah. Ah, okay, all right. Okay, okay. I got confused because of the... Okay.
Oh, all oops, right. I guess... Yeah, I guess I did cast it twice. Sorry.
I had marked already the 11, but...
That's fine. 11. I didn't see that it actually rolled damage before. Sorry.
No problem. No problem.
Okay, I'm done.
Okay. Is that your turn, Mist?
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Klaatu, your turn.
Yes. First, my skeletons keep attacking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 19?
She her AC. Yeah, her AC in this form is 18.
Okay, so.
So that 13. Is 13 points of damage. Then 11.
Then another 11 and 12.
Then another 11 and then. Well, okay.
What a good round. Good job, my skeletons. And then it's time for me to polymorph. And you see Klaatu getting bigger and hairy. And a giant ape appears with black hair and white. Skin.
Yeah, you destroyed the mushroom you were standing under. There's like lots of spores flying around.
Yeah, why not?
Bet that ape's coughing like crazy.
And then I will run over here. I will move.
My... Is that ape bigger than it was before?
I don't know. It seems like it. It must be huge.
Stat block says it's huge, so that's right.
Okay, alright, well.
Giant ape. I have now multi-attack. Is that... Oh no, that's like I do multi-attack with one action. So... Mm-hmm. Okay. Alright, then this is my turn. I can send actually here to get the aura of mist. So huge. Miru would be very angry, very jealous.
All right, you will throw a sticky bomb over on this area, creating a 20-foot radius tar pool. Okay, I'm gonna need to hijack one of your skeletons, Clara.
Oh no! Use Clara.
Okay, I can just. We have a measurer, so I'm gonna use that. Token, all right.
I'm just kidding, you can use whatever you want.
This is gonna be a tar pool. Black 20 radius that everyone can. Alright, so she's gonna throw the tar over here, so everyone there must make a dexterity saving throw.
Me.
Okay, alright. Everyone must make a dexterity saving throw.
Okay.
At the start of your turn, if you are not tarred, you must make the dexterity saving throw again. If you enter it, you risk being tarred again, okay? The point is that it will always try to tar you this area, unless it is discarded or disbanded for some reason.
Okay. Thanks.
Right. Okay, so this creates... Okay, so everyone must make a dexterity saving throw, everyone except Justin. Alright, the DC is 20. On the saving throw against Tar. So, everyone with below 20. Remember that Mist is giving some people his aura.
Yeah, plus 3.
I'm probably too far away.
Yeah.
Actually, at the moment, the only one that's getting the aura is the ape.
The only one in the aura is the ape.
And Kurt. I guess Kurt is too.
And Kurt, yeah. Okay.
Right. Okay.
So,
I made it.
And Kurt get plus 3, I believe. Everyone else is tarred, and tarred means that you are under the effect of the slow spell. Again, you can use an action to try to untar yourself. Right. Then... it will use the move through tar as it melts and reappears over here, teleporting itself. And then it will make an aimed...
Okay.
Yes?
Did Justin notice this being magical, or...?
It is an effect, basically, that it has.
All right. All
right. It, it basically melts and teleports away closer to Orava and pukes at Jast in an attempt to tar him. Does a 20 hit?
Yes, but then it would also take the cold damage before it teleports away.
It is not in melee, so the teleportation...
How far can it puke? So it's more like a spit. Okay.
It pukes at a range of, I think it's 45, yeah.
Right, so 20 acid, so exactly I have in range. 9. So I take 11 acid to my hit points, bring me down to 110.
Right then. And you do become tarred. So you are now under the effect of the slow spell. Again, you can do the acrobatics or athletics check to remove that out of you. It looks now at Orba with a wicked smile that pierces its way through the blackness. There's only these teeth. Orava, your turn. You, it is on fire, so you at the beginning of your turn, suffer 2d6 points of fire damage.
2d6.
In a 10 feet radius, you suffer.
Yeah, in a 10 feet radius, it will just... You'd suffer 11 points of fire.
And I'm tarred as well, right?
If you fail the dexterity saving throw, then yes.
Yeah, I failed.
Alright, I'm gonna put these slow things, slow markers on you. Did any of the skeletons make the tar check?
Yeah, one. Kurt the first.
Kurt made it, okay.
I will throw a TP bomb over, way over there.
Okay.
No, where's the attack?
We already established you can't miss because you have a plus 10 or 11 or something.
Yeah, okay, so if you have a plus
10... Ah, but it only goes 30 feet. It only goes 30 feet. I guess. Main. I think I will go here.
Go away from the tar maid, go further than 10 feet away, otherwise she teleports.
Considering that you are under the effect of slow spell, you can either use an action or a bonus action, not both, unless you are hasted.
Okay.
So if the bomb requires you to prepare, you cannot do that.
Yeah, it does. And does it also cut my movement?
It does, yes.
Huh.
It cuts your movement in half. And remember that you are poisoned, so that is cut further by 5 feet.
No, but didn't he misheal that, right? That one poison.
Miss, did you heal the poison from Klaatu or from Oruba or both?
On me.
Oh, that was on Oruba.
Oh, okay. That was on. Then... That was on Oruba, not Klaatu.
Also,
I'm sorry, Klaatu. It was on Klaatu, no, not Oruba. Okay. Sorry.
Okay. Okay, so Oruba, you have lost 5 feet of movement from the poison. You make a constitution saving throw to see if you lose another 5 feet.
He got that poison too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you lose another 5 feet. So you have, if you had 30, you have 20, and that is now half.
I have 25. So I have to... 15 now.
Oh, 15.
Sorry, Oruba, I wasn't aware you had it too.
Oh, it's fine. I'm just gonna take the potion of haste that I have. And then I'm hasted, so now I... Basically, I just use my bonus action for that, but then now I just have an action, right?
Yes.
Then I guess I just bomb her. Okay, I will first throw the bomb and then I will try to... Oh, that's 18. And no, that's 15. It's 15, I think, right? That's bless. Yeah, I don't have bless. Fifteen doesn't hit, right?
15 does not hit, no. A 15 does not hit, but it does hit the tar. The tar starts to catch on fire.
Uh-oh. I will move here at least. 15 feet.
Eustace, that's all tar made, right?
Yeah, but if I move up, I'm just more isolated, right?
I feel like it can't get to you that way because it can move through the tar. And it's going to make damage in a 10-foot radius, so the more closer we are, the more damage we take. But I don't want to... If you think Oroba would roleplay-wise go to the others, he would.
I mean, it's through the tar, so me and Mandy also just want to get out of it. And it's my turn then.
Alright, Justin.
I'll be right back for as well.
I'm going to try to break out of the tarred state.
Okay.
What is it?
Acrobatics or athletics check?
Acrobatics! 18. I'm going to add a d6 if necessary. Going to 20.
20, so 20 succeeds. Alright, so you shake off the tar.
Yes. And then
that
I'm going
take your
to.
Action,
yes. Then I'm going to use a bonus action.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait, I do have my movement still, right?
Yes.
Wait. Sorry, but isn't Dimension Door a bonus action to cast?
Yes.
Why
Dimension
is it
Door?
My... Yeah.
Pretty sure it's an action.
Wait.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. One of those teleportation things was a bonus. No, Dimension Door is a...
Misty Step is a bonus
Misty,
action.
Yes, Misty Step is the one. Alright. So I have my movement now, which is 30 feet.
Hmm?
Yes. But let's do 5, 10, 15. I don't want to go inside of the tar. Who is it going to go for? Let's see. So Justin is going to move here.
Hmm? 1 second, I'm just putting the fire, the tar that's on fire.
Hey guys, yeah. I just realized I'm going to have to go in about an hour.
All right.
Oh, okay.
Yes, okay. I'm going to end my turn here.
Okay, then. Missed your turn. Okay, actually, as a as a legendary action, considering it does not see, it will use the... It is going to use the aimed puke against Mist.
Ooh.
Okay, I'm sorry. It's doing what against me?
It's two natural ones.
Oh, and nothing
puke.
Apparently.
Okay, all right. Well, it tries to puke on you, basically trying to consume the tar to throw it onto you, but it kind of seems to choke onto itself. And just utterly fails to do whatever it wanted to do. Mist, your turn.
Okay, so explain to me again what happens if I move in the star.
Okay. At the start of your turn, you have to make a dexterity saving throw to see if you become tarred or not, because you started in the tar.
Okay. I'm pretty sure I'm already tarred, though. Yeah, because I only rolled a 12 on my original
okay.
save.
Alright, so you... Okay, I didn't mark you as tarred. Okay. Alright, so you can move freely through the tar. but you always risk being tarred, basically, whenever you move through it and into it. So it is a point of... You're basically free to move inside of this area, but you always risk becoming tarred. If you're already tarred, you don't get more tarred.
A tarred means suffering under the effects of a slow spell?
But I'm already hasted, so I'm basically normal.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, it still is that you can't use a bonus action after you used an action. Even though you're hasted.
Haste and slow counter each other. They specifically say so in the spells.
I would say that yes. They would just counter each other. So you are normal.
I will use my bonus action to Misty Step. Up next to Oruba. Let's see, that took me... Okay, that's from there. Okay, so I should still have... it was right there. Should still have 20 movement left. Okay, I'll reach out and use... lay on hands. Heal him for 13. And I should also remove any poison or... petrification effects on him. Unfortunately, it doesn't remove the slow.
That's
but it will remove the poison.
Yeah, the poison and the petrification effect.
Okay, all right. So you feel basically your limbs starting to unpetrify, your poison starting to leave your body. You're free of it for now. All right. Is that your turn, Mist?
And I healed you for another 13 with that. So, how are you looking, Oruba?
You heal me more? How much?
I healed you for a total of 13 when I touched you with laying hands.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have half my HP.
Oh, so you're still bloodied?
Yeah.
Klaatu, where are you? Oh, you're the ape, duh. Crap. Okay, I will... As my haste... Oh, I don't get a haste action. Never mind. I'm done.
Right then. Athel will use the aimed puke now against.
Oh, do I get a save against? To hit. Do I get a save against that slow? At the end of my turn?
I'm sorry?
At the end of my turn, do I get a save against the slow? The tar?
No, it's at the. It's on your turn, you can use an action to try to remove the slow.
Oh, that's the only way to get rid of it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Is it a DC 20 what save?
It's an athletics or acrobatics when you choose to use it on your turn. When it is used as a saving throw, it's a dexterity.
And what's the DC if you do it on your turn?
It's still 20.
Okay.
Klaatu, it will use an aimed puke at you with a 27 to hit.
Will hit.
Does that hit you?
Yes.
Okay, that is 19 points of acid damage, and you become hard.
Okay. Oh, I can't. Oh, wait. Yeah, yes.
Make a concentration saving throw.
I have it with advantage because I'm a warcaster. I use a luck point. Oh, yeah, right.
No, you don't succeed.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah.
Ooh. Lucky me.
Barely,
I guess.
But you succeed.
Yes.
No, you succeed by 2. Yeah. No. Only you would have failed on a 9.
It is barely.
So, Klaatu, your turn.
Okay. Angry Ape pulls out a big rock and throws the rock against the creature. Big rock. Throws the rock again.
Alright, that will hit. That is 38 points of bludgeoning damage. Okay, alright. Well, the creature takes the whole thing and missed as you're standing partially behind it. You feel like you just see this, like, flammable, almost like a meteor shower showers onto your armor and basically it doesn't really do anything, but it just makes it quite ugly.
And the skeletons keep attacking. Pew 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 pew. 1, 2, 3, 5.
Hey, you got a crit.
Yeah, one hits.
That is a crit, yes. So that is 12 plus Wait. Another 2. Okay, right.
As I'm kind of patting out the little chunks of flaming tar on my armor, I kind of give Klaatu a dirty look. Watch where you're throwing.
He doesn't understand you. No, he does. He's not sweet. He grins a little bit.
Alright. As it's final legendary action, it will actually move closer to this location over here. Alright. At the start of its turn, it will change form again. This time the fifth form. Which is... Alright, it is the stone form.
Interesting.
Psychic damage.
That's bad for you, right?
Yeah, I mean, psychic damage is annoying. But how is it with magical damage?
It's immune to it.
Yeah.
Okay, alright. Stone form. Upon taking this form, Atl gains 25 temporary HP.
Bludgeoning is okay. Cool.
Alright, that's it. This is its change of form.
Is the tar still there?
The tar is still there, yes.
Mm.
Alright, it will move up close to Klaatu. Actually, it will gain a size, and it will move. It will use the crushing blow with a 26 to hit against the ape.
Yes, it hits.
Okay, so it punches Ape Klaatu with all the force that it has, dealing 55 bludgeoning damage. Make a strength saving throw.
Holy shit.
Okay, you are pushed back. Make a concentration saving throw.
Mm-hmm. Beep.
18 is not half of 55. No. Alright, so you get knocked back into your form. You are stunned and you are knocked prone.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I guess I take the damage as Ape and then transform back,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you take the damage as the Ape.
I'm not prone then.
Why are you transferring back? It said you had 135 health.
Because he lost his concentration.
Yeah.
Oh, gotcha. I'm sorry.
Yeah. No. Am I still tarred then?
You are still tarred, yes.
Oh.
No. Actually, you wouldn't be tarred because you left outside of the tar. Alright. The stone form is actually going to move closer to you and then will use another attack.
Oh no.
Bye, Klaatu.
The sure hit, basically it concentrates its force on one arm and then just plunges that as hard as it can into you. The attack cannot miss, and it deals 33 bludgeoning damage.
I puke. I'm not built for that. Get out of this.
Alright, then it will move, merge into the earth, and sink down into the ground.
Oh god. A really bad
form. So it basically sinks down into the tar pit, and is now somewhere in the ground. People with tremor sense can see him, can sense him. Creatures with tremor sense. But essentially, it is outside of this place.
Okay.
That is its turn. Orba.
Do you need some health, Klaatu?
Probably. Otherwise I would flee, I guess.
I have a prepared painkiller bomb that I will throw at him.
I can get in my ape form again, but yeah.
And then for my bonus action I would take another healing potion.
That'd be... So 17, 10? And the healing?
Okay.
No, the healing 17. Is just on a crit.
Okay.
Oh. Shit, I'm also still slowed. I could have tried to shake it off. As I can also only... No.
That would have been your action, though.
Yeah, but then I'm still hasted. I would have gained the action back. But I do it next round, I guess. I'm just gonna try and hide a little bit behind the skeletons.
Oh, yeah. That's what they're for.
All right, then. Is that your turn, Oroba?
Yep.
Okay, Justin.
I can't see it, right?
Yes, unless you have a way to see through walls.
Nah, I don't. Are these mushrooms covered with tar as well?
Yes.
Alright, I want to jump onto this mushroom then, like on top of it.
Okay, the tar is not expanding. The tar is not expanding, but the fire is.
Yeah, then this one.
Oh no.
And I'm going to hold my action to fire the last shot of the lightning bullet. Yeah, to wherever he appears.
All right, missed.
I'll move forward a bit. Then I'll cast Song of Melora. So everyone gains 12 health.
Nice, back to full.
Including any skeletons who need them. Needed. Mm-hmm. Okay, that was a bonus action. I'm gonna go ahead and try to break my slow. You said athletics or acrobatics? Damn.
Nope.
That will not succeed.
Okay. Okay, then that is where I'll stay. Here, my turn's over.
Right.
Who wants to run my character while, or when I have to go?
I think we're going to stop when you're leaving. We've got most of the time in the game, and then we can all say when it's possible to play next week. Don't worry.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Orava, below you, you sense this fist erupting from the earth as Atl uses a legendary action to use the crushing blow on you.
And as she emerges,
where is it? Yes. All right, that is a 20 as she just emerges, erupts from the earth to give you a crushing blow. You, Justin, shoot before it does the attack.
23 to hit.
23. You are shooting with advantage?
Yes, I always do. Either I use grit or I use the sharpshooter feature where I lose my movement. So.
Yes, I keep forgetting. Sorry.
But this time I used grit because I had to move up to the mushroom. So it's the lightning lure shot. So that's 16 mm-hmm. piercing damage, which she is, or she is what?
Yeah, the piercing doesn't do anything to it.
Yes, but the lightning maybe. So that's 4d6.
Is he even immune to magical piercing?
It is immune to all piercing.
Well, crap.
Yes. So that's 21 points of lightning damage.
Okay, 21 points of lightning damage. All right, Orava does a 20 hit.
Yep.
Okay, so you are stuck with a crushing blow. It comes from below, and the shot almost propels you into the air. Make a strength saving throw.
Oh no, all that good healing and I'm stunned.
Okay, you are projected over here and you are stunned. And not prone. Alright, round break, the fire spreads another line.
Uh-oh.
Okay, all right. The fire is quickly spreading through the tar. Klaatu.
Mm-hmm.
Your turn.
I am stunned and not prone. Can I still talk?
I don't think so, no.
Oh. So I'm just puking. Spitting blood and stand up. Oh, God. And I'm happy that I got a painkiller at least. My skeletons will still attack. There's a... Yeah. Pew, pew, pew.
Okay, what is the type of damage that the skeletons do?
Piercing, but they still attack.
Okay, then there's no point in rolling for them because...
Oh, that's so sad! Oh, that's so sad! It's already two natural 20s.
Well...
I'm sorry.
That's a game. Yeah, and that would be my turn. I can't command them. I did action and stand up, and then stunned.
Right then. Mm-hmm. Apple is going to change form again. The pen form. Really not in a good position for the 10th form, but all right.
Is it the ultimate form? The final form?
It's not the final form. It changes form now. Be a water type creature.
Oh, sweet.
But it's not in a good location to be a water creature. All right, so it will start pouring water on this area. Basically, it starts to call water to fill this area. This area will slowly expand.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, it will counter the tar.
Nice.
Player luck.
Yes. All right, right now it starts with a 10 heat radius. On his location, send it to the back. Right, as it erupts, yes, all right. So the creature calls for water, basically to start forming around it. It will move. Yes, it will. It's still an amphibian, so it will move over here to attack Oruba. And... go. Right, it will attack Oruba with the blood in the water. Blood in the water has advantage. Yes, because Oruba is stunned. So that is 19 points of slashing damage.
That downs me.
Okay. Oh no!
Right. You are bleeding. Well, make a constitution saving throw to see if you are bleeding.
No.
All right, so you are bleeding. At the start of your turn, you suffer 1d12 damage. And it stacks. It is a condition, and it's like poison, so it can be washed away with lesser restoration and spells like that.
I hate to say it, but at the beginning of his turn, he loses a death mm-hmm. save, and then has to roll again for another death save.
Mm-hmm. So no natural ones, my mate.
Your ass better not roll that one.
Right. It will then summon choking waters onto Justin.
No saves and stuff?
Let me see. I might have forgotten to put a saving throw on this. I guess it would be a dexterity saving throw. Yes.
Yes, it does say at the end of it. The dex saving throw 20. Ooh! Natural 1 plus 3 is 8. So no.
Yeah. Alright. You will get the chance to redo the saving throw at the end of your turn.
But I take half of it.
Okay. But you take 19 points of bludgeoning damage. it as basically water, it starts swirling around your head and constantly slapping your face really hard. Mm-hmm. You cannot speak, you are deafened, and you are blinded. Unless you succeed on a perception check on your turn.
Okay.
As you are trying to see still through the water that's swirling around your head.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then it will move over here. It will move over here and try to hide behind this mushroom. Oraba, you lose a death saving throw, and now you must roll the saving throw yourself.
Nice.
Okay, you succeed on one, you have failed on one because of the damage. Justin.
I'm going to make a perception check, right? See if I can see anything this turn. Ooh, net 20.
Alright, yes. It's not only on your on this turn. Once you have succeeded, you are not blinded anymore. You are still deafened and you can't speak, so you are still choking because of the water.
Right. With this check, do I also see her hiding?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to bonus action activate the Canopic Edge, and I'm going to run over the mushrooms, and I'm going to make it seem like I don't notice her, but then I jump down behind her and try to stab her in the head.
Okay, alright. Make the attack then.
Oh, that's a 21 on the first attack.
You want it?
18 points of damage, and she can't regain hit points. And then another 26 to hit. 28 points of damage. It's psychic. I think it's only psychic now. I don't know why it says slash radiant. I think I should pull it out.
Because you're rolling two. You're rolling two different kinds of damage there, 2d4 and 2d8.
Yeah, but it all changed to psychic once the Canopic Edge got mad.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Even with the spell with the spirits, it's all psychic now. Ah, anyway. So.
Alright.
That ends Justin's turn. Because the Canopic Edge is activated, she has 10 feet less movement.
Mm-hmm. Alright then. Legendary action, she is going to use... Where is the... Ah, there we go. She is going to use the Blood in the Water attack against you with a 14.
Misses. She's
rolling terribly.
Yeah. I'll grab her arm and say... Poor woman. I know you like to be up close with me, Atul.
You see that her response is like a licking of these of teeth that is perhaps an attempt to be seductive? You're not sure.
No. You're not sure it wasn't a good attempt.
Missed.
Then you have to go.
Okay.
Do you have to go now?
No, not yet.
Okay.
Sorry, I was responding to a text. Mist will run up here. Cast. Whispers of Melora on Oraba.
Maybe more than a d12.
So the
bleeding doesn't kill him at the start of his next turn.
Yeah, I'm looking at my spell slot to see how high I want to cast it.
I mean, I have to get away somehow as well.
Yeah, but you're also bleeding, you know? You could take a d12 at the start of your turn, and before you can do anything, you go down again. It's a shitty position.
Yes, but he will die if he misses the next saving throw.
Yes.
The next death saving
throw. Crap.
Yeah.
15.
No, it's good. It's good. 15 right. is enough. Hopefully.
Yeah, well, I was hoping for a lot more.
What could it have been?
And that was third, so I heal for 5. And then I will use my action to try to beat the hell out of this.
Oh, I loved how Justin came above the mushrooms, and at the same time you came, like, healing him and then running from below. Such good bashing.
Yeah, alright. So that is one crit and another attack that would hit.
I am going to...
Yes, yes.
Divine Smite on that crit.
Alright.
And I will make that a level 5 Divine Smite.
So I'm guessing that's going to hurt a lot.
Oh, yes,
oh yeah.
It's like, it's monster type of damage. Paladins are crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that was... That was for the crit. And that is the normal attack.
Okay,
and we can read the damage as is, or is something different?
The only difference is you don't get the Radiant versus Undead box. Everything else should be...
Okay, and everything okay. else is Radiant.
Yes, everything else is Radiant.
Yeah.
I am a Radiant Beast.
Yeah.
Okay, without counting the Radiant versus Undead boxes...
Justin jumps above the mushrooms and attacks the creature from below with the canopic edge, and then mist charges, throws a healing whisper of Melora to Oraba, and then stabs through its chest in a way that is so deeply in that it almost hits Justin himself.
Wah.
Yeah.
Let's...
Holy shit, though.
113.
And don't from the fuck with my friends, Adam.
Incandescent radiant damage that just surrounds it.
Nice.
And you will not take my form again.
That was what, right? That was the start of it all.
The creature turns and says, and it spits on mist, and as it does, it uses the choking waters on him as well. So as he spits, this little ball of spit increases in size, gathering from the mist around him, and surrounds now Mist's head. Make a dexterity saving throw.
Nice.
Okay, you succeed.
Okay, and how do we get rid of the spit thing?
Alright, so...
But the spit should get rid of the...
You succeed, so basically, as it tries to throw it onto you, you dodge it out of your head, and it kind of locks onto your shoulder plate. So, the water is still there, kind of hitting your shoulder plate, but not really doing anything with that. And you are just not affected by it.
But, since there is now water washing around me... The Targo's way, right?
Yeah, it cancels it out, you said.
It cancels it out, yes. So you have no tar anymore.
Okay. I like that.
Okay.
Not really sure how tar would affect my form anyway, but I didn't argue that. I mean, I am water.
Let's not make this more difficult than it needs to.
But that is my purpose, is to make it difficult for you, Mateus.
So, Klaatu will command the skeletons. Go away, go out of the tar! Shake it off and then attack again. and they try so. Everybody but Kaminsky comes out. Whoops. 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 So they will take their action to get rid of this slow effect.
Except one of them?
Yeah.
Why doesn't Kaminsky come out?
And the speed is also halved. And 15 is not.
Gotcha.
Hmm?
Gotcha. Sorry. I. Yeah.
Don't mind.
Ignore me.
And I will polymorph me again. Because I love the giant ape.
I want to get rid of away from the tar first, though.
Yeah.
Okay, the fire, because of the round break, the fire is spreading still through the tar.
But so is the water spreading, right? But this time from this origin where we are at?
Oh,
yes,
I can.
The water spreads, yes, but the water spreads on Atl's turn.
Okay.
Just for clarification's sake, I don't want this to be more difficult than it needs to be.
Many terrains.
Yes, there's a lot of many terrains, and the creature itself has a lot of different abilities, so yes, lots of stuff is
happening. Okay, so... guys, unfortunately she is here. My nurse is here, so I'm gonna have to go.
But it was round break, right? So after Klaatu's turn, it will just be Atl starting us off again next time.
Mm-hmm.
That is true, yes. Okay,
so Klaatu, when is next time?
Take your turn then, and we'll stop then at Atl's turn.
Mm-hmm. I will just move and then it is what it is.
Okay, what are we playing again?
Monday?
Next week, Monday?
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's fine with me.
Okay, so okay. The 14th.
Yes, the 14th. Alright, nice.
I'll see you all then.
Alright then, guys.
Yes.
Yes, have a good one. Greetings to
Goodbye.
The
night.